Hello and welcome to part 3 of this 4-part video series on generating X parameters from circuit level designs. My name is Jack Sifri, and in this video demo I will show you how to generate an X parameter model with two input tones that can be used to determine intermodulation distortion products and third order intercept point. But first, let me briefly explain why designers and system engineers pay a great deal of attention to these third-order terms, especially in receiving systems. These third-order intermodulation distortion products are usually introduced in a system by components such as mixers and amplifiers. So, to determine the third-order distortion products on such components, a two-tone test is commonly used. This test generates two tones of the same power, but separated by a very small frequency offset or spacing. These two tones mix together and generate higher-order distortion products at different mixing frequencies, as shown here. For example, the second-order distortion products and some of the third-order distortion products are generated far away from the passband signal and can be easily filtered out. However, some other third-order terms, such as the 2F1-F2 and the 2F2-F1 terms, happen to fall very close to the signal in the passband of the system and cannot be filtered out. They bring trouble to the system and need to be accounted for and kept at lower power levels as compared to the main receive signal in the passband. So, let us now focus our attention on those critical intermodulation terms that fall in the passband of the system. From these third-order distortion products, let us define two specs that help us specify the linearity of a system. The first spec is the intermodulation distortion, IM3, which is the amplitude difference between the fundamental tones and the third order term. It is measured in dB at a given input power level in dBm, and it changes as we change the power level. The red arrows here illustrate how for every 1 dB increase in the fundamental tones, there is a corresponding 3 dB increase in the third-order intermodulation distortion products. As we keep doing this, the third-order terms become equal in power level to the fundamental term, and this theoretical output power level becomes our second spec for linearity of a system. It is called the third-order intercept, or TOI. This spec is the output power at which the third-order distortion products become equal in amplitude to the main signal power. Now, let me point out that there is another commonly used method to determine this third-order intercept point, and that is by extrapolating the linear P-in-P-out lines of both the fundamental tone and third-order tone from their small signal linear range all the way until they intersect at the point where they are equal, and that would be the TOI point. Let me now show you how easy it is to generate a two-tone X parameter model in ADS. I will use the same power amplifier circuit that I had used in the previous demos. And by the way, you can generate a model with more than two tones in ADS, but in this demo, I will use a two-tone model generation. Generating a two-tone X parameter model is very easy. All you have to do is insert your circuit in this template, just as we did in the previous demos, but now we want to have a two-tone source instead of one. So by double-clicking on the source, you can see that I have inserted two tones that are equal in power, and also you can see that I'm sweeping my input power from -20 dBm to +10 dBm. The rest is very simple. Just click on the Simulate button and the two-tone model is generated and automatically placed in the data folder of the project. So next, let me test my generated model and see how the results compare with the circuit level design. Here, in this template, I simulate the circuit level design with two tones using harmonic balance simulator. And here are the results. Using the same exact template, I now insert my XParameter model and simulate. And here are the results. Notice that for this simple two-stage power amplifier, the model simulated in 3 seconds, which is about 4 times faster than simulating the circuit level PA. It's important that I mention here that the simulation speed using the XParameter model could get as high as 100 times faster than the circuit level design, as the size of the circuit gets larger and more complex. The best way to show the accuracy of the model as compared with the circuit level design is to overlay the two results on top of each other. What you see here are the overlaid results of the fundamental tones and the third order terms of both the XParameter model, shown in blue, and the circuit level PA, shown in red. The results are identical and the model is very accurate. In fact, I thought I should also display the results in numerical format in order to clearly illustrate how close and accurate the model's results are as compared with that of the circuit level PA. Look, for example, at an input power of -10 dBm. The fundamental terms are 14.278 versus 14.280 dBm. This clearly demonstrates that using the XParameter model is identical to having the actual circuit level design. And on top of this, you get IP protection to your circuit design topology. You can transport and email the model to anyone and anywhere within minutes. And you can use the model for system verification and trade-off analysis with much faster simulation speed. Now, here's a template that calculates and plots the third-order intercept point from the data I just showed. Notice the third-order intercept point, TOI, using the circuit-level PA is 38.82 dBm. Now, if I change the data set to read in the XParameter's model instead of the circuit-level PA, notice the TOI becomes 38.79 dBm. Again, this illustrates the accuracy of the model as compared to the circuit level design. We have a third order intercept of 38.82 versus 38.79 dBm. That is very accurate. Let me recap now with a few important points. With these generated XParameter models, you get high accuracy, fast simulation, and fully IP-protected models to your design topologies. System integrators can receive these models in few minutes, by email or FTP, and they can use them to evaluate their system design and do a quick trade-off analysis. And they can concurrently feed back information to the design houses and allow the system to pass in much shorter time and with first-pass success, saving weeks and months of development time and achieving design wins with first-to-market their products. In the next video, part 4 of this series, I will show you how the XParameter model is used in system simulation and wireless verification with much faster simulation and verification speed. Thank you for watching this video. For more information on XParameters, please visit these two web pages. Next, please proceed to video demo number 4 on using XParameter models in wireless verification.